नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनाभूतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माण विदधाति पूर्व वेदागश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मिन् तगुम्ह देवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रीचिद्भवनगणेशं सुखं नित्यं सत्प्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपयोः अधिष्ठानं स्क्रीन विजिबल सृष्टि श्रुति नाम लय चिंतन द्वारा अद्वैत तात्पर्य Why are this Srishti Shruti is there? If you say that Jagrat Prapancha is like Swapna Prapancha, meaning Samakala Utpatti and Samakala Nasha, Jnana Utpatti, Samakala Utpatti of Jagrat Padartha also, and Jnana Utpatti, Samakala Eva Utpatti and Jnana Nasha Samakala Eva Nasha, Jagataha. If that is so, then why will Shruti talk about the creation, manifestation, whatever you call about it, with Krama, so much of detail? And this is an objection from an Advaitin, Srishti Drishti Vadin, the Trisatta Vadin. So Shruti Shruti is not committed to the Shruti itself. We have seen yesterday, it is Adhyaropa, and that Adhyaropa Sthaniya Shruti has to be refuted by the Apavada Sthaniya Shruti. So, Shrishti Shruti Naam Laya Chintana Dvara Advaiti Tatparyam. Towards the end of the Panchamataranga, we saw that the way the Shrishti Krama has been mentioned, the reverse of that is the Laya Chintana Krama. It helps Upasana, it helps Dhyana. For a person who is unable to understand the Tatparya complete, it is not Manana Siddha, and one does not have Nishtha, for that person, Dhyana is recommended. In which fashion? In the same fashion as the description of the Srishti. Reverse to that should be the Layakrama. सृष्टि क्रम प्रतिपादक श्रुति नाम न सृष्टौ तात्पर्यम् किंतु ब्रह्मणा अद्वितीयत्व बोधने एव फाइनली बाय शोइंग कार्य कारण प्रक्रिया कारणात् भिन्न कार्यस्य सत्ता नास्ति दिस इज द मेथडोलॉजी यूज देयर बाय इन एवरी कार्य इन एवरीथिंग दैट यू कॉग्नाइज यू हैव टू एनालाइज वेदर इट इज अ कार्य और नॉट इफ इट इज अ कार्य देन कारण इज सत्य कारण कार्य इज मिथ्या You keep on doing that till you end up in that karana, which is never a karya. So sarva karyanam yat karanam, yasya karanam nasti tad brahma tattvamasi, which is ekameva dvitiyam. That is the commitment of the shruti. That is the culmination of the shruti also. Including the Srishti Shruti. Srishti Shruti Tatparya is also to take you by hand-holding unto that goal. So, Sarve Padartha Paramatmana Eva Jayante Iti Tad Vivarta Bhuta Eva. But how so? Because Brahma is Vivarta Karana. So, when you say Paramatmana Jayante Sarve Padartha, then Paramatma is Karana. What kind of Karana? Vivarta Bhuta. These Padarthas are Vivarta Bhuta, the Paramatma is Vivarta Karana. यद यद विवर्तभूतम तत्तत् स्वरूपमेव भवति. इन द रज्जु सर्प एग्जांपल, रज्जु इज विवर्त कारण, सर्प इज विवर्त कार्य ऑफ रज्जु. मीनिंग रज्जु नेवर चेंज. इफ रज्जु नेवर चेंज इन टू सर्प, देन सर्प इज भ्रांति. नाउ वेदर यू एक्सप्लेन अ क्रमा इन विच दिस भ्रांति केम अबाउट, oh, first this happens and that happens, this is a necessary condition there, that kind of person is needed, he should have some samskara. You talk about everything, it is nothing but a story. Do you understand that it is a bhranti? Then your job is done. How that bhranti takes place, why do you want to do that? It is like, you know, there is this nyaya which is used. A person is giving up the honey which is right there in his hand, but he is trying to lick his elbow where some honey is. You know, just because he was trying to process honey, that time some honey came about on his elbow, but he is giving up the honey which is in his hand, in his palm, but trying to lick the honey off the elbow. Why would you do that? You already have what you have, what you wanted, right there in front of you. So, bhranti explanation is the tatparya. You do apavada and move on. And this is what is explained even in the Chandogya Upanishad, Shashto Adhyaya. Acharyavan Purusho Veda. This person who has been hijacked from, basically, he has been abducted from Gandharva Nagara. Gandharva Nagara. So there, this Gandhara Purusha, Gandhara. So from that Gandhara Nagara, he has been abducted and left out in the forest. He is directionless because he does not know how he was brought in. His eyes were covered. He is still blindfolded. He is yelling out. He is tied up. He does not know where to go. So somebody who frees him and gives him a direction as to how to go, this person has an acharya now. So acharyavan purusho veda, this person knows the direction. He has to just walk the path without getting distracted. So there it is said, this medhavi purusha, there the discussion of medha comes in. This medhavi purusha who has understood the mapped out path for him to take, and also pandita, why? He should understand it and he should remember and not get lost. He should stay the course. So if you know the goal, he wants to reach back Gandhara Nagara. He should not get entertained by whatever is on the way. Even if there are examples used, you know, the person who is showing the way is going to tell him that you will hit this town. There is a circus going on there, whatever, you know. Elsewhere, there is a Ratha Yatra there. Now, this person is going back home. He has been away. He has been in affliction. Why would he look for entertainment around the way? He is not interested in some jatra going on anywhere. He should not get lost there. Similarly, the examples given, the krama given, this is all to drive home the point that this is your goal. So you should not become Srishti Chintaka. Bhagwan Gaudapadacharya's word for this is Srishti Chintaka. Those who spend entire time in how this Srishti happened, what came first, what came later. Go to the Tatparya. So with that in mind, we'll just speed through this. Now, yad yad vivarta bhutam tat tat swarupam eva bhavati. So the prapancha appearance, sarpa is nothing but rajju. Prapancha is nothing but brahma. Why? Because nama rupatmakam prapancha nasti eva. This nama rupatmaka prapancha is mithya and in Paramarthika perspective, drishti srishti vada, it is tuchya, it is not even mithya. Na tato tirichyate. It is not different from Brahma. Adhishthana of prapancha is that vivarta karana, and karya being vivarta of that, it has never changed. Therefore, it is not a parinama of something. You need not look of krama where nothing has happened really. Ataha nama rupatmakaha sakalah prapancha brahma avyatiriktataya brahma eva iti imam artham bodhayitum eva srishti srutihi pravrutta na anyat prayojanam asti srishti srutihi. So srishti srutihi anyat prayojanam nasti. Anyat prayojanam nasti. There is no other purpose at all. Person who is looking into the krama, discussing the krama, thinking of the krama, trying to understand the krama, trying to refute anything else that contradicts that krama, has been trying to look for a purpose which is not intended at all. Tatra srishtau yakramaha uktaha tasyapi stuladrusham pumsam utpatti krama viparita kramena paramakarane brahmani sarvakaryalaya chintana dvara advitiya brahma avabodhanaya eva iti advaita bodhanam eva prayojanam. So what is the prayojana? Advaita bodhana. Even for those people whom srishti krama is useful to do laya chintana, for them also that krama is going to be useful only if it lands in advaita brahma. Those who can land on advaita brahma without the krama can directly jump there. Person who spends a lot of time on the krama itself, what use it is going to be? Only for laya chintana. And sarva karya laya chintana dvara advitiya brahma avabodhanam. That is the purpose. Tasmai avabodhanaya evaiti advaita bodhanameva prayojanam. Natu akashadinam utpattu kramabodhaneva tesham paraspara karyakaranata bodhaneva srishti shrutehe pramanyam. This srishti shruti is not pramana at all. People think that no, shruti says it is pramana. It is not a pramana. You don't see this akashadi krama taking place really. You can't put them together in that manner. So what use is it for you, alaukika, or you who is trying to get away from samsara? For both, it is not going to give any value addition. Does it talk about some phala? Shruti cannot be talking about some phala rahita krama also. If Shruti is talking about some phala of this, what is the phala of this? You understand the Shrishti krama, at the most you can, you know, give some Indian philosophy paper on a particular aspect of this and get some certificate or a degree. You may land yourself a job, but not only just by this part, you'll have to do a lot more other than that. So laukika phala is not there. Paralaukika phala is also not there because there is no mention of phala saying that srishti krama understanding will drive you to this loka. The only phala is the advaita jnana prapti avabodhana. And for that krama is not necessary at all. Because through krama, what is established is karya has no existence without karana, even in that trisattavada. Srishtau nasti kramaha kintu sarve padartha ekasya eva avidyaya sakashad utpannaha. Avidya has been said to be the moola karana. Moola vidya is the moola karana for your bhranti. Brahma is the vivartha karana, but for your bhranti, what is the karana? Avidya. Since every padartha is appearing due to your avidya, then whether first the padartha 1 came up first, padartha 2 came up second, or first, that is not going to give you anything. No additional mileage at all. All of these are avidya karya. If you have understood it, then why do you care for krama? Because that krama is also avidya krita. So srishtau nasti kramaha, even if the srishti shruti talks about krama, krama is not there at all. Bhagavan Bhashyakara says somewhere that it is not, it has been discussed earlier also. Yugapat srishti it isn't. What is it then in this krama? Because ही वॉन्ट्स टू ड्राइव द स्टूडेंट हु इज इंटरेस्टेड टू नो एंड वॉन्ट्स दैट पर्सन टू गेट मोक्ष इवन इफ इट बी थ्रू उपासना ऑफ लयक्रम. सो ही कांट कॉम्प्रोमाइज दैट श्रुति देयर. इट इज नॉट टारगेटिंग द उत्तम अधिकारी. सो भाष्य इज इन कॉन्टेक्स्ट. सृष्टौ नास्ति क्रमः. But if you look at the Prakrana Granthas, there you should see what Bhagavan Bhashyakara says. He'll not say something else completely, but he is free to say something by bringing in his own context. So, Srishtav Nasti Krama Kintu Sarve Padartha Ekasya Eva Vidyaya Sakasha Utpannaha Tatra Parasparam Karekarana Bhavo Va Puro Paschat Kali Natvam Va Avidyakrute Swapne Eva Mithya Eva Pratibhasate. That krama or the karyakarana bhava is all mithya, just like it is mithya in swapna. Swapna putra and swapna pita, they have pura paschat bhava, karyakarana bhava, all that is mithya because putra and pita are avidyakrita, yugapat, and their krama and their karyakarana bhava is also क्रमा मीनिंग पूर्व पश्चात भाव और पूर्व पश्चात कालीनत्वम बोथ आर अविद्याकृता एज वेल. श्रुत्युक्तम आकाशादीनां पूर्व पश्चात भावित्व कार्यकारणत्वादिकं तु कारण व्यतिरेकेण कार्यं नास्ति इति मंदानां लयचिंतनार्थं कृतम्. सो देयर इज अ टाइपो हियर. सो मंदानां दोस हु हैव दीस क्वेश्चंस and they cannot understand the tatparya directly, you know, there are quite a lot of us who have been through this experience due to someone else or yourself. You know, there's a class going on even in school or in college. The teacher is discussing something, the professor says something and someone asks a question, he says, don't worry about it, I just mentioned it in passing. So it was a mention in passing. Those who want details, they can hold on to it and move on. But if the person holds on only to that, which has nothing to do with the syllabus, which has nothing to do with the examination, which has nothing to do with your progress or anyone's progress, the person holds the class. Everyone else is irritated because this person is holding a class. Nobody else is interested in that. You discuss this off the class. You find out on your own. But let the class move to the tatparya, because he's saying that it is just mentioned. I take back my words. I don't want to discuss that. Maybe it is wrong. Focus here. But the more you tell the person, this is not the tatparya. Well, the example given is, do not think about a monkey. What comes into the mind is the monkey itself. That's why sometimes the meditative process does not work. The same meditative process won't work for everyone. Someone tells you, you know, you focus here. You're already focused. Someone tells you, you set aside everything that you are thinking about. Set up, you know, don't think about your wife and children. This fellow is a brahmachari. He has no wife or children. So even that pratyahara that you are asking a person to do, the person does not have it. And now he is thinking about that. So you have pushed the person who is already meditative out of meditation. So this samuhika meditation does not work really. Dhyana cannot be samuhika. Samuhika dhyana is bogus, in my opinion, of course. My opinion is just one opinion. You cannot have this. There is nothing called as, you know, there is nothing called simultaneous moksha. Let's have karma mukti. Let's all go to Brahmaloka. It's not going to work. The spouse is not going to accompany you, let alone the other, you know, co-sadhakas or whoever these are. So it's an individual sadhana. More so because this individual should understand that there is no one else. There is no other jiva. Finally, there is no jivatvam also. That person cannot be doing samuhika, anything samuhika. Nonetheless, whatever is the focus, one has to be there, not elsewhere. Therefore, मिथ्याव प्रतिभासते भासते एंड देन श्रुत्युक्तम आकाशादि पूर्व पश्चात भावित्व कार्य कारणत्वादिकं तु कारण व्यतिरेकेण कारण कार्यम नास्ति कारण सत्ता व्हाट इज दिस कार्य इट इज नॉट देयर एट ऑल देयर बाय मंदानां लय चिंतनार्थं कृतं यथा वस्तु स्वरूपमस्ति तथैव ध्यानं कर्तव्यमिति नियमो नास्ति ब्रह्म इज निर्गुण ब्रह्म सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म दैट इज द लक्षण वाक्य नाउ द सृष्टि क्रमा फॉलोज विच इज अ व्याख्यान ऑन दैट इफ अ पर्सन अंडरस्टैंड सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम दैट सृष्टि क्रमा इज नॉट नेसेसरी एट ऑल यू हैव ऑलरेडी अंडरस्टूड सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म अनंतम अनंतम विल टेल यू दैट देयर कैनॉट बी टू How do you know? You cannot have two infinities. Mathematical impossibility. So when you say Ananta, Brahma is Ananta, then you cannot be outside of it. Ananta cannot have parts. It is Chetana Vastu. It is Satya Vastu. So Lakshana itself tells you that Satya means whatever is existent. That is Brahma. Are you existent? Yes, Brahma. Is this Prapancha existent? Brahma. Everything that there is Brahma. But I already knew that everything exists. Okay, set that aside. Come to Jnanam. Then the discussion on Jnanam, if you understand, and Jnana is Chetana Swarupa Chit. It is not Dhatvartha also. It is not Bhava Sadhana. It is not it cannot be Sakarmaka Dhatu. Why? Because Anantyam will negate it. So, Satyam Jnanam, when you land on Jnana, you know that it is not Jada Vastu. Brahma is Chetana Vastu. There cannot be multiple Chetanas because Anantyam will negate it. This Chid Vastu is one. There is no expectation of another. Karma. There is no Karaka Bheda. Now when you come to Anantyam, it will take away every other possibility of existence of anything at all. Because Lakshana Vakya has already told you, whatever exists is Brahma. Whatever is Chetana is Brahma. What about Jada? Jada also cannot exist at all because there is no Anantyam possible if Jada exists. Then I am Brahma is known by inference, by looking at Anantyam Shabda. By Lakshana Vakya you can understand this. And then I cannot be bhinna in any way. So this srishti krama is what? It is all mithya explanation. Therefore, mandanam laya chintanartham kritam yatha vastu swarupam asti tateva dhyanam kartavyam iti niyamo nasti. Now someone tells you, you look at this krama, you look at this, you look at that. Dhyana can be any which way to understand the swarupa. To understand the Swarupa, you can use the Krama, reverse the Krama. So Dhyana is very individualistic. As long as you land on the goal, there is no issue at all. Vastu Swarupa can be understood without doing Dhyana on the Vastu Swarupa itself. You don't need to say Satyam Jnana Manantam Brahma on that, I'll do Dhyana. You can do Dhyana on Laya Krama also, Srishti Krama also, and say from me all of this has come about. That is all right. Because there is no niyama that dhyana should be exactly in keeping with the swarupa. Because if you want to do that, swarupa is ekameva advitiya. Dhyana itself is contrary to it. The dhyana needs triputi. Triputi is contradictory to brahma swarupa. But still, dhyana has to be facilitated. So swarupa bhinna dhyana. It is always swarupa bhinna dhyana. So vastu swarupam yatha asti tatha eva dhyanam kartam iti niyamo eva nasti. So niyama is not there, so srishti krama is explained for the purpose of laya chintana dhyana, which is divorce from the vastu swarupa. As long as it leads there, it is okay. But tatparya is not that. Tasmat jagrat padarthanam api parasparam karya karana bhavo nasti eva. दृष्टि सृष्टिवाद एव अंगीकार्य So in the end, this is what you have to accept. You can't hold on to three satta and not drop the other two. Pratibhasika is dropped when you reach Vyavaharika. Vyavaharika has to be dropped when you understand this Paramarthika. You cannot hold on to it and keep on arguing endlessly. No question is going to be answered in the end. In the end, you will have, all questions have to be dropped. They have to resolve on their own. The more you keep on asking questions outwardly and stepping out of Paramarthika, you will remain there. So this is the idea due to which Drishti Srishti Vada Eva Angikarya. Finally, this is what is the Tatparya of the Shruti, which is what Vivarana also explains. It is a shortcut method for an Uttamadhikari, for a Mandadhikari also, who has to in the process become an Uttamadhikari, or in the end, if he wants Jivan Mukti, not Krama Mukti, then he has to understand that Tatparya of the Shruti, Advitiya Brahma, where Drishti Srishti Vada is what he has to land on. Because he cannot say that I'll get Mukti, others will be Baddha Jivas. He has to finally end in Eka Jiva only. So many Jivas are there. Swami Vivekananda went out and made a statement and he said that nobody should work towards one's moksha unless one frees others. So others are still there in your perspective. That is Seva Bhava. It has nothing to do with moksha itself. There are no others. This is what you have to understand. There are no others. The person who says that there are others, he has not understood Advaita Tattva. Loka Sangraha is a different perspective. It is at a Vyavaharika level and in Drishti Srishti Vada, it is also Pratibhasate. It is a Pratibhasika Satta. It can get done due to Prarabdha. So one has to let that go. But if you look at the Advaita Tattva understanding, when a person understands that, then there is no other Jiva. I, the Sadhaka, have to attend this Sadhya Brahma by Jnana because I am not different, I wasn't different, I cannot be different, I will never be different from this Brahma, which is the only existent Tattva. Then where is the scope for Jivatva Bhava, individualization, to separate yourself from anything or anyone? There are no other Jivas. Therefore, Drishti Srishti Vada Eva Angikarya. Then what is this Prapancha which is there? Sentient and insentient. It is an appearance to me, the Eka Jiva, who is Brahma Abhinna Jiva. To me, there is an appearance. And that appearance, if I say it is created, manifested, then it is simultaneous with my Drishti. What is that drishti? It is a bhranti. It has no existence at all. Thereby, drishti srishti vada eva angikarya paramarthatastu jagrita padarthanam api karya karanatvadikam kinchidapina sambhavati. So in jagrit padartha also you cannot have a krama or the karya karana bhava. Sarve api padartha sakshad avidya karya bhuta shukti rajatadivat swapna vachya. So swapna padarthavat, or in the Brahmasthala, Shukti Rajatavat, Rajyasarpavat, all these are Jagrat Padarthas, Avidya Karya Bhutaha. They are Avidya Karya. Sakshad Avidya Karyatvena Pratibhasikatvad Avidya Vrityupahita Sakshina Eva Sarveyapi Padartha Prakashyante. So this Sakshi Chaitanya, who is segmented out by Avidya, that unsegmented Brahma Chaitanya somehow getting a nama as Sakshi Chaitanya, that Sakshi Chaitanya lights up this avidyavritti of not only Swapna or the Bhrantisthala Padartha, Rajya Sarpa, Chukti Rajata, but also Jagrat Padarthas, because they are avidya karya. And we have seen how this cognition takes place in Bhrantisthala also and outside Bhrantisthala also. But outside Bhrantisthala, meaning where Rajju is seen as Rajju, that time also that Rajju is Avidya Karya in दृष्टि सृष्टिवाद दैट अविद्या कार्य इज लिट अप बाय द अविद्या उपहित चैतन्य अविद्या वृत्ति उपहित चैतन्य अविद्या वृत्ति इज दिस पदार्थ रज्जु जागृत पदार्थ दैट पदार्थ इज लिट अप बाय द बिकॉज देयर इज एन अविद्या वृत्ति अविद्या कार्य दिस अविद्या वृत्ति टेक्स प्लेस एंड देन दैट अविद्या वृत्ति इज लिट अप बाय साक्षी चैतन्य देयर बाय साक्षी सेज आई नो दिस रज्जु there is no rajju at all there is only avidya vritti and that itself is the karya really avidyayah jnyakarah jnanakarascha parinamah so parinama vishaya and jnana these are the two things how does the vishaya come about how does the jnana vishaya jnana come about so vishaya jnana and vishaya these are the two differentiations and in the earlier part we saw तमोगुण अंश परिणाम ऑफ अविद्या इज विषय एंड सत्वगुण परिणाम अंश ऑफ अविद्या इज व्हाट दिस विषय ज्ञान इज सो ज्ञेयाकार विषय एंड ज्ञानाकार ज्ञान दैट ज्ञान इज ज्ञानाकार दीज टू वृत्तीज टेक प्लेस अविद्या ज्ञेयाकार ज्ञानाकार परिणाम युगपद्देव उत्पद्य युगपद्देव नश्यति स्वप्नवद्देव They are simultaneous. Rise simultaneously, go away simultaneously. Vishaya also, jnana also. Darshanam srishtir adarshanam layaha iti nyayat. Yada padarthav pratiyate tadaiva pratiti vishaya padartho jayate. Whenever you have a cognition of anything, then that darshana itself is srishti. Adarshanam itself is laya. When you see, there is srishti of that vishaya. When you do not see, and seeing is an upalakshana. When you hear, When you taste, that time the vishaya comes about. Along with the jnana. Natu kalantare padarthotpattir asti. Ayam eva drishti srishti vada ityuchyate. Natu kalantare. There is no other kala other than this srishti and laya kala which is srishti darshana kala, adarshana kala. So darshana kala is when srishti is and adarshana kala is when that padartha vinasha is. For whom? Whoever is cognizing. What about the others? There are no others. No, but I know, I discuss with the person, there is another. That other has come about when you had that other darshana. Did you see that person who talked to you? Yes. How can you say it as pratyaksha pramana? How do you know? Other does not exist is your opinion. My anubhava is that the other is there. You are there who is talking to me, arguing with me. That you and that other, whenever you had that darshana. So Yajnadatta asks Devadatta, tells Yajnadatta, tells Devadatta, there is no other. So Devadatta says, Devadatta is telling Yajnadatta. Yajnadatta says, no, I spoke to the other yesterday. He told, so I know that the others and this prapancha exists. I was sleeping, but the prapancha was there. There was other kala also where in at different times he exists. When did you speak to him? Yesterday. That other kala, when that other person existed, who Yajnadatta witnessed, Yajnadatta's darshana of the other, let's call him Chaitra. So Chaitra darshana by Yajnadatta was in a particular kala. During that kala, there was Chaitra Darshana when Chaitra Utpatti took place. What about his words? All the discussion. That discussion what Yajnadatta heard, Chaitra make all these arguments. Those Shabdas, Shabda Utpattis were also when Yajnadatta had Shabda Darshana. Shabda Darshana is Shabda Shravana. So you have to appropriately change the word based on what is cognized. So whenever anything is cognized by anyone, at that moment, that something is utpanna. And whenever one ceases to have anubhava of that particular shabda sparsha rupa rasa gandha, that time there is laya also. Now what about this? Devadatta who is discussing in the in this kala, there is no Chaitra at all, because in that moment he came up and he went. There is no Satta at all. What about this Yajnadatta and Devadatta Samvada now in this moment? There, Devadatta, who is the Jiva Sadhaka, who is inquiring, to him this Yajnadatta, who is the Guru, Yajnadatta, who is inquiring, to whom Devadatta is the Guru, this Guru is also not there. Because Yajnadatta Sharira is also not there really. That Sharira cognition is there, that Sharira is also Tatshana Utpanna and Tatshana Nasha it will have when there is no cognition in Swapna Avastha or in Shushupti Avastha. So this is Drishti Srishti Vada. What about Vyasacharya Shankaracharya? So all this argument will, these questions would come up. So who is that Eka Jeeva? Whoever is the Sadhaka is the Eka Jeeva. What about the others? Are they Sadhakas? Then in their own perspectives, they are Jeevas. Eka Jeeva. That there are other Jeevas is also Bhranti of this Sadhaka, whoever that is. There is only one Jeeva. There is only one Sadhaka. Sadhaka Jeeva has a Bhranti of all others, whether things or sentient or insentient. Ayam eva drishti srishti vada iti uchyate. For that, there is a tippana now. Drishti, what is drishti? Drishti itself is srishti or drishti samakala srishti. These are the two pakshas we saw earlier. Details are not given here yet. Drishti avidyavritti rupam jnanam. What is drishti? It is avidyavritti rupa. We already know what is vritti. Antakrana vritti we know. Avidyavritti also we know. In the Bhrantisthala, there is avidyavritti. When Ishvara Srishta Padartha is there, they Antakarna is cognizing that. So Rajju in the Trisatta Vada, in Trisatta Vada, there is Vyavaharika Satta where Rajju exists, Pratibhasika Satta is where Rajju Sarpa exists. That Sarpa is Avidya Vritti Rupa, whereas Rajju is Antakarna Vritti Rupa. Somehow it is amiss to the person who is having Bhranti. So there we say it is Avidya Vritti, Sakshi Bhasya, not Jiva Bhasya. So drishti is avidya vritti rupam jnanam, and this is in the case of Jagrat Padartha as well as Swapna Padartha as well as Bhranti Stala Rajju Sarpa or Shukti Rajata in Drishti Srishti Vada. So that drishti itself is what is jnana, and what about the srishti? That is a vishaya padartha tadutpatti samaye eva srishti. What is srishti? Drishya prapancha utpatti. So prapancha utpatti is there. Now you talk about krama, all that krama is yugapad. Whatever is cognized, that itself is going to come up in that moment. Asya arthasya pratipadanam drishti srishti vada iti ajata vada iti cha kathyate. Now people say, oh, ajata vada is discussed. Why do you focus on drishti srishti vada? Drishti srishti vada is ajata vada. How so? Ajata vada is saying is Brahma is aja. Na jata iti ajaha. So Brahma is not born at all. What is drishti srishti vada saying? It is not born. Brahma is not born. So asya arthasya pratipadanam drishti srishti vada iti ajata vada iti cha kathyate. So people say, no, drishti srishti vada is not going to give you moksha. Finally, you have to land on ajata vada. Oh, drishti srishti vada is ajata vada. That is the argument that never has anything come up at all. Ayancha vado brahadaranyaka upanishad, but it is not talked about in Upanishad. Why do you bring it up? Stick to this srishti krama ityadi. Bhagavan Bhashyakara does not talk about it. We'll stick only to Bhagavan Bhashyakara's words. We'll stick only to Shruti. How much of Shruti have these people studied who to make such a statement? Even any person alive today, anyone cannot make a statement unless he's a Siddha, you know. Siddha, we say, okay, Krantadarshi. A person who does not accept Siddhis, does not claim Siddhis, refutes Siddhis even and says Siddhis are not at all the goal. They are not the goal and they are not to be focused upon. Siddhis are also mithya. that person making a statement that this is not an Upanishad Vakya, it is not there in Upanishad, so we should focus on this Upanishad. That person cannot make a statement that there is nowhere it is covered, because out of so many thousands of Upanishads, only 108 are considered authentic today, because they are the only ones surviving. There has been mix up by invaders. They have created their own Upanishads, Allo Upanishads and whatnot. They have all got into even Chaukamba books. But even in this Muktika Upanishad, mentioning these 108 Upanishads, these are there or not there, to make such a statement, the person has to have studied those 108 Upanishads. There are not many who have studied 108 Upanishads. They are not taught. Even out of these 10 on which Bhagavan Bhashyakara wrote Bhashya, they do not know why he wrote Bhashya on those 10. Because Muktika Upanishad talks about them. There is nothing called as primary Upanishad, main Upanishad, secondary Upanishads, or you know, minor, major. All this division is Western. It is an invasion into our Shastra. There is nothing called as a main Upanishad. Any Upanishad that takes you to the goal is your main Upanishad. People are born in their own sampradayas. Their own sampradaya Upanishad is there because your own shakha is there. That will give you mukti. It may or may not be a so-called main Upanishad. One statement can give mukti. Without Upanishad, something derivative of Upanishad can give you mukti. Smriti, Purana, Itihasa, any of these can give mukti. Those which have translated these works into other languages without even giving credit, created the cults and the religions, that also can give mukti because of Shruti Vachana, which is going to take away your ajnana. That is the tatparya. So this Drishti Srishti Vada isn't there in the Shruti, is a statement which has no backing. Now let's say it is not there, whatever is there, Drishti Srishti Vada or anything, is not there in 108 Upanishads. Somebody searches, does not find. One does a group of researchers finds it and they can't find it, and they say this guru has made this statement. It is valid. How is it valid? What about the other Upanishads which have lost, which are burned, which are destroyed? How do you know they are not there in that? You don't have those siddhi. That person, that your guru does not have that siddhi. Where did he come to know from that it is not there in any Upanishad? Because Upanishads are not available. They have been destroyed by invaders. Vedas have been destroyed. So it should not be assumed that since I do not know, since my teacher does not know, it is not there. A person can say, I do not know, I do not see it in these Upanishads. But to say that it is not in any Upanishad, or it is not in the Upanishad that Bhagavan Bhashyakara has commented on, so it is not in major Upanishad, that major Upanishads is a mithya creation for whatever purposes is irrelevant to us. But even if you say it is there or not in this and this other Upanishad, you keep on handpicking Upanishads and say it isn't there. Everything is there in Brihadaranyaka. Brihadaranyaka has everything. It is so vast. Therefore, Tippanakara quotes this. Ayancha vadaha Brihadaranyaka Upanishad Bhashye Vartike Mandukya Upanishad Karikayam Tadbhashye Tatra eva Anandagiri Vyakhyane Vasishthe Suta Samhitayam Vedanta Muktavalyam Atma Purane Advaita Siddhau Anyeshu cha Vedanta Granteshu Pratipadyate. And how Atyadarena Pratipadyate. This Drishti Srishti Vada is the commitment of the Shruti of Vivarna. These people who belong to Vivarna Sampradaya also, they say that Drishti Srishti Vada is bogus because of illiteracy, nothing else. And that illiteracy continues because their teachers didn't teach him, which is okay. But to call something else as bogus, as Sampradaya Krita, something as revealed by the Shruti itself as bogus, is not right. You can tell the person that you don't need it. Let's not focus there. It is a little tricky, whatever. But to say that it is wrong is itself wrong. That is all I am saying. Because it is there in Bhashya itself. Brihadaranyaka Upanishad talks about it. Therefore, Bhagavan Bhashyakara talks about it. It is not his own Swakapola Kalpita. Bhashya is always in context. And being in context, something which belongs there is brought about from other Upanishads or other places in the to explain the context, to justify the context, to justify the explanation of the context. That is Bhashya. It is Prasanna Gambhira. You cannot say just by study of Bhashya, I've got everything. In fact, study of Bhashya is study of Mula. If you read Mula, it is not study of Mula, because Mula is so complicated, it cannot be studied at all. Directly, you can be chanting it, you cannot get the meaning. Even Vyakrana Artha you won't get, because even with the complete Vyakrana study, Chandasa Prayoga has to be told by the Bhashya. Bhashya study is study of Mula. How do you study the Bhashya then? You study the Bhashya by studying the Tika. These people who do not study Tika, they say Tika Kara has said this, they have said that, all that. That is all their own understanding and misunderstanding really. Those who do not value the Sampradaya, they cannot claim Sampradaya. Tika Kara is in the Sampradaya. Tippana Kara is in the Sampradaya. Each and every person who explained this to me and my teacher this is all Sampradaya. It's a lineage. How can you break the link and connect yourself to Bhagavan Bhashyakara directly? You cannot. Oh, I understand the Bhashya. I don't need Tika. Fine. But who taught you the Bhashya? That person has studied Tika. If he has said that Tika is useless, then he has not studied Bhashya. That person has studied Mula. This is the Shraddha one should have in the Sampradaya. Then it fructifies. It fructifies into Jnana. It becomes Sthira. It blesses. So it is there in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, it is there in that Bhashya, it is in Vartika also, Bhagavan Sureshwara Acharya has written that, it is there in Mandukya Upanishad Karika, Bhagavan Gaudapada Acharya has written Tad Bhashye, Bhashya on that Tatreva, Anandagiri Vyakhyane, Tikakara explains it, then Vasishta is Vasishta Ramayane. Oh, Vasishta Ramayane is not Shruti, says the person who does not know how these are, Itihasa Purana, everything is connected to Shruti, unless it does. Unless it contradicts, it is Pramana. Because all these are derivatives of Shruti. Suta Samhitayam. Suta Samhita is that work which Bhagavan Bhashyakara studied 8 times. I think 8 is a number, I don't recall. Before he even started creating Bhashyas. He was inspired by Suta Samhita not once, not twice, 8 times he studied that. This is Sampradaya. So Suta Samhita is that on which Bhashya is influenced by. It is that on which Bhashya is based really. Basis of the idea of the Bhashya comes from Sutta Samhita. Vedanta Muktavali. So Vedanta Muktavali, Vedanta Siddhanta Muktavali is also there. So there you have this discussion of Drishti Srishti Vada. Atma Purana. Atma Purana. Purana itself is about Atma. Purana is also Pramana there. Advaita Siddhi. Bhagavan Madhusudana Saraswati Acharya talks about it. All this analysis is done. Anyeshucha Vedanta Grandish. There are many. Pratipadyate and not, you know, just as another methodology, Ati Adarena. Atyadarena. With a lot of respect because it is the Vada of Shruti. Real Vada of Shruti. Everything else is to help you come to that particular position to understand that perspective. Vishesha Jinyasavaha Tan Granthan Avalokayeyuhu. So the Tippanakara says that those who are interested, they can look there. But then immediately he says, Akke Chen Madhuvindeta Kimartham Parvatam Vrajet. He says, on the corner of your house, Akka, on the corner of your house, village house, you have, you know, the bees forming honey. So if you have honey on the corner of your house, why would you go searching for honey in the forest, parvatam, in mountainous areas? Now this is when people had no access to honey in the shops directly, or whoever is could extract honey. So it is right here in this Sagara Rupa Grantha. It is so elaborate, it covers almost everything. Why almost? It covers everything and more. It covers everything that is there elsewhere in more detail, more depth. So, of course, there's repetition many a time. And it is so in so much of detail. It is right here. Why would you go searching for anything else? Because he has extracted every bit from all of these places. He has discussed Advaita Siddhi. He has discussed what is discussed in Vedanta Muktavali. Sutta Sanhita he quotes at times. Vasishta Ramayana he quotes. He takes things from Tika, Bhashya, Upanishads, Karikas, Vartikas. Everywhere Sadhu Nischala Dasji has taken cue from, he has taken learnings from everywhere and has created this Sagara Rupa Grantha. Therefore, Akke Chen Madhu Vindeta, here itself you find it. Kimartham Parvatam Vrajet. Why would you go to other granthas and study them? Too complicated and spread out so much. So here itself you are going to get it. Iti nyayena etad granthyeneva jidnyasunam drishti srishti siddhanta jnanam samyak jayate. In fact, this drishti srishti vada has also not been discussed in so much of detail anywhere else. Advaita Siddhi has it, but then it is too, it is not the only thing that is discussed there. And it is Tarka Rupa Grantha. Advaita Siddhi study is so complicated that you need 2 to 3 levels of Tarka study, Nyaya study before you reach there. And of course the other Prasthanatraya, because it is part of Brihat Prasthanatraya. But all of that is explained here in a simplified manner so that everyone can understand it. Iti Nyayane Etad Granthyeneva Jidnyasunam Drishti Srishti Siddhanta Jnanam Samyak Jayate. Not only Jayate, Samyak Jayate. Everyone can understand it very well. Granthantaravalokanantu tesham buddhi vinodaya bhavati. You have time, you have nothing else to do because this is your life. Then buddhi vinodaya, you feel happy to study this, you know. As you know, Pooja Swamiji and our Acharya used to, you know, you look at your at the mirror, you are not looking at the mirror for the sake of the mirror. You want to look at the mirror to look at your own, you appreciate your own beauty in the mirror. Or you want to make yourself beautiful in the mirror, what you do later or what you do earlier is irrelevant. But when you're looking at the mirror, you are looking at yourself. So these all this buddhi vinodaya, when you look at the other granthas also, you are looking at your own self, how it is revealed there. Itopyanyo drishti srishti vadosti tatra. There is another drishti srishti vada also. This is one which is explained. What is the other? Satta sarva padarthanam nanya samvedana drute jnana swarupam evahur jagad etad vichakshanaha artha swarupam bhramyantah pashyantyanye kudrishtayah iti. So what is the other drishti srishti vada? What is discussed here is samakalina srishti. Drishti samakalina srishti. Srishti is there. Yes, we accept srishti. What kind of srishti? Vivarta srishti. But at the same time that this jiva has drishti. But drishtir eva srishti. There is no srishti which is different from drishti. Your drishti itself is srishti. In the earlier case, you can say Ishvara is creating when I see. Ishvara is creating when I hear. He manifests something when I taste something. All this is possible. In the other paksha of drishti srishti vada, Ishvara is not treated as bhinna at all. Jiva abhinna Ishvara. Because this jiva, when he sees, that itself is srishti. Satta, sarva padarthanam satta. Samvedana dhrute anya na nasti. So sarva padarthanam satta. What is the satta of all? Satta ka sarvapadarthanam. Just knowing it. Samvedana dhrute anya nasti. There is no other satta. My seeing it itself is satta. So that itself is srishti. Jnana swarupam eva ahuhu. So what is the swarupa of these padarthas? Satta, sarvapadartha satta. What is it swarupa? Swarupa is jnana swarupa itself. Jnana swarupam eva ahuhu. Then this is the aropa by even the so-called well-learned people in the sampradaya. Unfortunate. Partial study. Studying Drishti Srishti Vada on their own. Sampradaya isn't there. They don't take these works as pramana. Trying to look for some statement, one-off statement in the Bhashya. Maybe it means that, but it does not mean what the Tika says, what the other places it is discussed. That is incomplete study. All these people who have written about Drishti Srishti Vada, it is from the Shruti Pramana, Bhashya and Tikas. They have referred to all of this. They are quoted. So it is not that one person who has studied some Bhashya, he says that oh, Drishti Srishti Vada is all, you know, like Kshanika Vijnana Vada. That will also be discussed. But Tippana is going to come up. Artha Swarupam Brahmyanta Pashyanti Kudrishtaya, but Advaita Vichakshanaha Jnana Swarupam Evahu Jagat Sarvapadarthanam Satta Anyanasti Samvedana Drute Anyanasti Vichakshanaha Ahuhu. What do they say? Kim Ahuhu Etat Jagat, this Jagat which is Idam Jagat. What do you see this? Jnana Swarupam Eva Ahuhu Advaita Vishak. Those who have Advaita Drishti, those who have Kudrishti. Kudrishti is anything other than Advaita Drishti. Kudrishtayaha Pashyanti, Anye Pashyanti, Anye Kudrishtaya Artha Swarupam, not Jnana Swarupam. Artha is there, it is created by Ishwara, it is there outside. They are Kudrishtayaha Brahmyantaha, because they are Kshatranta Pada, Brahmyanta, Brahmyanta, Brahmyan. Yaha Kaschit Pashyati Artha Swarupam Pashyati Saha Brahmyan Pashyati. Confused. Sattantara nindapurokam sattaikatva pratipadanena jagataha tuchyatvam uchyate. In this paksha, not mithyatvam, tuchyatvam uchyate. Jagataha. Jagat cannot be tuchha, it is blasphemy. This, for this person, Advaita will not be sakshat. Why? Because he is stuck in this word blasphemy. He thinks that Ishwara is really there, who is separate from me. That Mahavakya will not work. For Mahavakya to work, he has to finally resolve Ishwara also. Ishwara cannot remain to be there because Jivatva Bhava has to go. Jivatva Bhava is there. He has held on to it and he says, I understand. It is like saying, oh, Ramayana is over. I understood everything. Who is Sita? I don't know who Sita Maiya is. Entire Ramayana is over. This is the case of a person who says this is blasphemy. So sattantara ninda purvakam, ninda of another satta has to be done. Ishwara has vyavaharika satta just like Jiva has vyavaharika satta, even in satta traya. So sattantara ninda purvakam satta ekatva pratipadanina. Then once you land on paramarthika satta, in paramarthika satta there is no jiva or ishwara. So why do you even think about the blasphemy and jagat? So jagat is tuchha there. So jagata tuchyattvam uchyate ayam eva sarvottamaha pakshaha. This paksha is sarvottama. What kind of paksha is this? It is very difficult also. It is uttama, sarvottama, but durlabhadikarikaha. So, ayam sarvottama paksha, sarvesham madhye uttama paksha, but durlabha adhikari yasya pakshasya sarvottamasya pakshasya saha pakshaha durlabhadikarikaha. Bauri, this paksha is that in which the dukhena labhyate iti durlabha. Where there is very difficult to attain paksha. Yes, Amma? Do you have a question? See a raised hand. Shailaja, Amma? Any, we'll stop here. If you have a question, you can ask. Sukhan nityam saprakasham vyapakan namurupe adhishthanam buddhya bodhyam buddher drakyatva nirvana param sarva vedanta vedyam pratyak param maha tadevahannam attonyaditi me nishchitamatihi. Any questions? Okay, by mistake, maybe they The hand is raised by mistake. Okay, namaste.
Hari Om.
Namaste.
Namaste.